Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Sentinel Worlds 1, Future Magic. There'll be no Let's Playing this time. Merely reading the extra paragraphs. As they say above, while you're enjoying Sentinel Worlds 1, Future Magic, you'll be referring to paragraphs in this book. We know that as a Federation Marine who enjoys the best of challenges, you wouldn't randomly read these paragraphs in search of clues. However, intense interstellar firefights coupled with breathing alien atmospheres can impair your good judgment, rendering you totally unable to resist. Fight your best here. Try not to read a paragraph unless you're instructed to do so. You'll get a lot more out of Sentinel Worlds 1 Future Magic this way. Once you successfully complete your mission in the Kaldor system, feel free to read the fictional vignettes during your long journey homeward. And we're going to do that now. Paragraph 1. Of course I know who's behind the raids, Brennan says. I've known all along. Every single one of those raiders is the lowest of the low, the kind of vile slime that hates puppies and hunts space bunnies. You know the kind, don't you? Here, let me clue you in. The raiders are the kind of folks who read paragraphs they shouldn't be reading. Now tell me, why do I always have to be the one set up to do the Federation's dirty work? I'm gonna get me a job where I don't have to tell folks not to do what they ain't supposed to do. Paragraph 2. The rancher stares at you and your crew long and hard before answering. Ranchers and farmers been fighting for the last 10 years. There's a piece of land we both have a hankering for because it's loaded with cransite. Folks in the Rowan system will pay you enough for a lousy handful of the stuff to let you retire. Federation don't know about cransite and won't recognize either side's claim to the land. You can see for yourself. It's right here on your chart at Nojan 1235-1108. Paragraph 4. The beasts eat our children, the Warhawken leader explains. Our weapons are useless against their scales. You must help us. They have slain all who venture near them. We believe there to be only a dozen or so, but we are powerless against their ravages. The Federation promised to help us in times of need. Go to Kaldor 1012-622 and slay them if you would honor your word. Paragraph 5. We dig because a great evil persuades us to dig. The evil stands above us like the shadow of the moon. The people dig, but our hearts do not dig. We dig with our teeth clenched, but I say to you, one day the teeth shall bite. If you want to know about the raiders, paragraph 6. If you want to know about the raiders, I'll let you in on a little secret, says Gregor in a low voice. Most of them do themselves in before you can get one word out of them. But I managed to get a hold of one that had a mind of his own. In a few words, this one was scared. I don't resort to torture, I assure you, but a little persuasion with these types isn't out of line. Gregor flashes you a grin, takes a long sip of his cocktail, then continues. This guy told me that they're equipping their ships with a modified weapon system that has twice the firepower of a Federation starship. That's all I could get out of him. He wouldn't tell me where his base was or whose boots he licked. I showed my appreciation by letting him ride with us. We strapped him to the prow of the ship. Paragraph 7. Let's see now, sentinels, eh? They're supposed to be a bunch of old men in blue robes somewhere in Nojan. My grandpa said he saw them once when he was on a hunting trip. Tried to talk to them, but they just scattered and didn't make a sound. Gramps was a pretty good tracker, but all he found was a few bushes stripped clean of fruit. Not a trace of the old guys. He also claimed that he saw some funny lights in the hills that night, and on a couple of other nights, too. Paragraph 8. Forget about the sentinels, young man. Looky here, I usually don't go in for fed types, but my daughter, she's just crazy about them. I reckon it's the uniforms or something. Anyway, you just relax. Ma will cook us up some nice victuals and we'll sit down and have ourselves a good meal, and then maybe we'll let you two youngins alone for a spell. Paragraph 11. To find the light, it is necessary that you unlock the gates of truth. The gates are hidden to those in whom the light is but a dull glow. but to those in whom the light shines forth, the gates stand forth with an unparalleled luminosity. There the masters wait in solitude. Paragraph 12. The Warhawken stares resolutely ahead. They are sometimes accompanied by others, not like themselves. They offer to trade with us, but we refuse. With such as they, we will have nothing to do. Paragraph 13. Look, he says, there probably isn't anything in that hunk of space junk. I bet you could sift through it until your fingers bled, your knees buckled, and all the chrome flaked off your new digital watch, and you still wouldn't come up with one stinking clue. But by all means, go ahead. I won't stand in your way. Paragraph 14. Yes, she says in a trembling voice. There is a door to the tower that's unguarded. It's a loading port of some sort. I can't tell you where it is, but there is someone who knows and who'd be willing to tell you. With a gasp, she clutches her throat. You stare in horror as blood streams from her eyes. She staggers for a moment, giving you enough time to step out of the way of her falling corpse. Paragraph 15. Kedro? Only a year ago, he was just like one of us, but something came over him, sudden-like. Some folks thought it was some space virus or something, but I never bought that. If you ask me, he just became... He pauses, tapping his forehead. Well, a little touched. Paragraph 16. The old man winks at you and nods his head sagely. Verily, the world is an oyster. Thou shalt not want. Paragraph 17. Well, I won't do it for charity, but I'm willing to make a deal, he says, taking another slug of red reactor. You get me a Federation contract and make it binding, and I'll get 'em for you, guaranteed. You come here with a signed piece of paper and we'll talk. Paragraph 18. If the Federation muscles in and you're not 100% on their side, you don't get no favors. No, I'm not satisfied with the way I've been treated. It's just not fair competition, you know. An advantage is an advantage. I don't care how you look at it. An honest trader like me doesn't stand a chance. Paragraph 19. Look, if you continue to read these paragraphs when you're not supposed to, terrible things could happen. You could go blind or get white spots on your fingernails. Either way, it constitutes a serious offense to the artist who has worked very hard to create this world and wants only your happiness. So if you would please just follow his rules, the world would really be a better place. Paragraph 21. I did see something strange once. They moved at an incredible speed. The cattle were scared, and me and my boys had to do everything we could to keep them from bolting. Weird, let me tell you. You could kind of see through them, see? Only they were a kind of sickly green color. That was back when my wife was still living, and when we come home, she said we looked like we'd seen a ghost or something. All in all, I guess we were pretty scared. Yep. That was the only time, though. Oh yeah, the next 21 is a 45. Paragraph 22. Delek lowers his blaster, then returns it to his holster. Well, you don't seem like the dishonest type, but I don't like someone who goes back on their word, and I don't like getting snaked. A deal's a deal. I expect the next time we meet you'll have the credits. I don't think I need to threaten a Fed. Motioning to his hired help, he turns and mounts the stairs. Paragraph 23. You enter the access codes and wait with a little impatience as the computer translates. With a quick flicker, a holographic representation of a tower appears before you. A flashing arrow points to a portal on the south side. Words appear below the image. 2210A2, security clearance, Lenka. Paragraph 24. Yes, sir, he handed me the Kaldor candy bar and said, read the ingredients carefully. And he emphasized carefully, just like that, carefully. So I opened the thing up, and lo and behold, there were numbers. There's these numbers scrawled on the inside. 1792, 955. I looked up and he was gone, you know, vanished. Paragraph 25. Follow me into darkness and you know that power is truth. I shall give you the knowledge by which you shall bring the world to its knees and recognize your personal divinity. I hold the reins of the world out to you. Do not turn them down. Do not choose destruction when I offer you full life. Do not choose weakness over your right to rule. Do not die for others when immortality lies within your grasp. Paragraph 27. If you ask me, there's something really fishy going on in that rift. It seems like farmers sure are heading there a lot these days, even when there's nothing of value there anymore. Several of us have seen them sneaking out there at night. Oh, there's something else weird about all this. We've been picking up strange transmissions over our radios. Stuff I can't understand. I sure don't like hearing what I can't understand. Paragraph 28. Well, I don't know if they actively helped the raiders, but maybe indirectly. You know, for a little information on the placement of military escorts, you know, like your ship, these merchants get safe passage. It's hard to believe we have such treacherous colonists in our midst, but they really exist. If there was some way we could catch the whole lot of them, we might just bag a few more raiders every month. Paragraph 29. The raiders you seek are in an underground colony on the ice planet. Malcolm brought them here from Earth and breeds them for his army. There's a secret chamber within the towers from which you could transport you and your crew into the ice domain. There you will encounter Malcolm and his minions. Beware of the counterwinding stairway. I can tell you no more. Paragraph 32. These beasts may be found toward the setting sun, beyond the sky pillars of emptiness where your vessels dock. Here, let me show you on this drawing where they reside. A comparison of the crude Warhacken map and Federation charts shows the approximate location of the invasion to be Caldor 640, 736. We might have used this one. Maybe it just has different coordinates. I don't know. I could be incorrect. Paragraph 33. The book is a book of spells. It is an artifact of the light that holds the knowledge we lost long ago. The evil one, Malcolm Trandall, the betrayer, stole the book when he stole our friend the Key of Thor. When we came to retrieve both, Malcolm used a great dark light to rob us of our youth and minds. He could not extinguish our minds completely, but our youth is lost to us forever. The light is bright in you. Perhaps we can teach you what you need to know in order to defeat Malcolm, but we cannot do so without the book. There are some basic abilities we still remember and which we will impart to you now. By taking from your heart to yourself or to your enemies, you can focus the light to heal injury to yourself. The power is yours now. You can sense the presence of other users of the light or of those in whom the light shines either brightly or with the dark pallor of evil. The power is yours now. You may probe the minds of others to know that which they seek to conceal, for the light illuminates the most obscure reaches of the living brain. The power is yours now. In order to teach you more, we must have the Book of Spells. Malcolm has hidden the book in a special location on the planet Earth. You may reach his location only through a transporter in one of his towers. You must go and retrieve the book.